running this earlier. It's an Axial Wroncho, as I call it. It's all merged between two of the RCs. Good, I keep you in frame. I got my GoPro mounted on my brim of my hat. My work area is always cluttered with something. But the problem I'm having with this, let's see if we get the controller. Hang on. Alright. For some reason, when I'm running this, see, I plug it in. I'll just show you. Okay, that's on. One of these controllers runs it. Not this one. That's down. This one. Okay. So, it's got an arm. Okay, so now it's going to work fine, but usually it's held off. The steering is acting weird at times, so what I'm thinking is going on is this servo is taking a lot of power demand from the BEC. That's the speed controller, but it also supplies the power to the radio, and the radio transmits through to the servo. You're in frame here, and what I'm trying to do here is get in here and see if I got like a loose wire, an exposed wire, some kind of interference issue, or I just have to line in a capacitor, because for some reason the steering goes all haywire. Wires look okay. I do see it right there in the exposed part of the signal line right there. Right there. Little spot. So, I'll put a little hot glue on that before they get sealed up afterwards. It's not acting up now. But let's take it outside and see if it starts to act up. Just set that there. Just lazily put this in there real quick. And see what happens. I'm going to take it outside, give her a whirl. That's good enough. That'll keep the wires out of the controller. I was doing it earlier. I was shooting a video. But it did it the other day too. And I never had a problem with this. And all of a sudden just starts doing this. So let's go give her a shot and see what happens. It didn't even get far. It's already doing it. See? That's doing it. As soon as I hit the throttle, it like lost, for some reason, that's what it's doing. So then when I unplug it, and plug it back in. Stuck. Shut the controller off, it returns to zero. Is it my controller, or is it the vehicle? So, process of elimination. I'll take this cover off real quick. Some of the battery. Shut the controller off. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and. Okay, there's batteries in this. Oh, and I left it on. How convenient. So. Let's go into the recycling. Let's see if these batteries are charged up enough. Make certain you're recording. I can tell. And hopefully you guys are catching some of this in frame. It's always easier when you have someone to record for you or with you. Okay, got this. Now, get this clear because I'm going to operate it. I'll get it flinging my clutter. Okay. This here. She's on there. Okay. here. Bind plug. Get in here. What we're going to do is remove this radio off and bind it to this one. So, find a bind port. Connect it in there. Just bind. I don't know if you can see that. Okay. Then you just hold the button here. It's on. And turn it on. But first off, power the ESC up first. It starts flashing. Bind. Power on. Boom. I'll just wait for it to set an arm. Get a confirm tone. And we're good. Okay, so now we have that established. Now hold it up. Aha! So I have an issue with the potentiometer, in this controller. So I gotta take it apart. Okay, problem solved. Let's get the bind out, and we'll just leave it stuck, bound to the ABC model of the Spectrum, Horizon Hobby Line, and we'll get this in, and some body pins, and we'll give her a test run and see if it's corrected. So this, that radio, it's got an issue. Weather cover back on. Boots. It just got done thunderstorming here, so. Also, I'm trying to see if I can follow the RC with this going on here. Alright, let's get this. Just find some body pins. See, I was going to line one of these in there. So, capacitor. You solder a JXT. One of those little connectors into there, and then it'll store reserve power, so if the ESC stops the unit from the motor, it doesn't take away from the radio, make it brown out, is what it's called. Causes glitching and rearming of your ESC and radios. Some models just don't, they'll supply the voltage, but the amperage is not there to sustain it. And some of those RCs, especially when you go high demand products, high demand engines and motors and such. Let's give this a whirl. Had to get the body on. Oi. I hope I was putting them in the right way, eh? Put this on there. Steering's off a little. There we go. Seems like it's working fine. So it was just my controller that was causing the issue. I have to take it apart and see what's dirt or dust or just it's worn out. Who knows? It's pretty steep. Once I get it groomed a little better, you know, for a scale version. Right in the face. Didn't get the tracking right now. Yep, that's pretty good. See, I can climb this hill right here. Oh yeah, like nothing. Locked out, I guess. Come on. Reverse it, sort of. Gotta wait a minute or a second and then go. Not used to that. And you can. Just trying to get to the top. Let's see. This looks like good. Oh! Okay. It's too gnarly. Too many tangles in here. Right. Oops, something's caught up. The tighten on the grub screws. I didn't lose anything, but well, I guess we're done. This is one of my friends sold it to me. Never used it. Tires weren't even glued on. So, you know, I went ahead and put them on. And I've only used it maybe 5 minutes so far. So. Alright guys, that's it. She's all fixed. Other than now, I just Gotta fix the drive shaft. Have a good one. Okay. Back in the little hobby lair. Get this drive shaft back on. Let's see here. About there. Knock those grub screws back. Let's get them crammed on here real good this time. We'll check the back side too, just in case. Okay. Crank this down. Okay, that's tight. Just double check these ones. A little bit. Got a little on it. Let's see here. Okay. I'm back in action. Yeah, there you go. Get the body comes back on and I'll be right back. Okay, get the body back on. Let's try this again. Yep, good to I think I'm stuck this time. Let's see if I can get out of this one. Oh, I did. Yeah, that was sort of. I'll go. Get into the crawlers a whole lot, but this one's it's cool when you don't have a track to run on. You can sort of go over everything with it. It's slow. I'm running a 3-cell lipo in it, 11.1 volt. I forget what it is, 4,000, 4,200, but such a low demand motor, you can literally run this for a good 45 minutes, unless you're, you know, running a lot of full bore. It's a lot of fun. Just a little billy goat. See if I can climb the ditch. Ooh, there's a lot of water in there. Best be careful. I don't want to get my water, my tires all soaked full of water, so we'll just sort of go around it. We'll flaunt with the water. Uh-oh. Am I going to roll it? Am I roll it? Nope, I got it. Lost the front drive shaft again. That's what I get for having two independent grub screws on that. I'm gonna have to put a through pin in there. Yep, just slipped again, that's all. I cranked them tight too. So instead of putting a grub screw in one side and in the other, I'm just gonna put a through pin right through. And that'll solve that problem. Alright guys. That's it for today. Just wanted to get out, share my experiences with RC. It's a lot of fun. Alright guys, till the next video. Stay safe. Any suggestions or comments or anything you have for me, put them down below. I will read them. I don't want to ignore anybody. Constructive criticism is always appreciated. But all right. Peace. You guys trip. You guys are so funny.